أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون
فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمداً عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. My dear requested brother, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. A lot of questions came to Colorado Muslims Fiqh Council regarding purchasing homes through university Islamic financials. Abbreviated UIF. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I don't know, and a lot of these brothers who ask these questions are local here in Colorado. Somehow, somewhat, they were informed that it's okay to do that, it's permissible to do that. Brothers, what do you want? Do you want a house to live in, or do you want to own a house? Be straightforward. Do you want to invest in a house, or you want a place where you and your family can live in peace without being at war with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or you want to make money? Be straightforward with yourselves. If you want a house to live in, then you can rent. There is no dire need. The dire need does not exist. The necessity which may make the unlawful permissible does not exist, because there are alternatives. But if you're after renting a house and after buying a house because it's money making, it's an investment, real estate and all that stuff, then you're after the dunya. Don't lie yourself. Don't stop asking these questions. Stop asking these questions. It's not, you're not, you know, you're going to keep asking every single individual because you know inside you that this is haram. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم الإثم ما حاك في الصدر وخشيت أن يطلع عليه الناس وإن أفتوك وإن أفتوك وإن أفتوك. A sin is what tickles your chest, what aches inside your chest. And you keep asking people. And you know what? This guy is going to tell you it's okay, and you're still going to keep asking because you know inside you it's haram. It's not right. I don't want to sit here and analyze what this institution does and what this institution does. I always use this line. The most, in my opinion, as a student of knowledge, the most lenient body of jurists, lenient in the sense of leniency, they make a lot of things okay. Somehow they find a way to make it okay for the Muslims in America, said the only time you're allowed to use this institution to buy a house, if you are in a dire need, which is called necessity. They should use the word necessity. What is, and they should identify what necessity, define what necessity is for the people. And they should say where this university banking or financials or whatever it is get their money to fund these houses. Let's be straightforward here. It's totally unlawful, brothers and sisters in Islam. Stop lying to yourselves. Stop finding leeways into this religion. You know, if you want to live by Islam, be honest about it and go and rent a house until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala finds a way for the ummah at large to solve the issue of home ownership in America. And I'm telling you, brothers and sisters in Islam, these halfway solutions, people really are in the business just to make money. Basically, they tell you, okay, you don't like the haram, we'll do the haram for you. We just want to make, we want to have a successful business. And you know what? They managed to get some guys who sign off their paper and for a donation they make to the institution or something. But you know inside you, it is still haram, is not right. So think of the house of Jannah, brothers and sisters. I know this is harsh, and I know this is difficult. And I know this is, to some Muslims actually, this doesn't make any sense. But I'm talking to the people who care about their akhirah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares war, Allah and His Messenger declare war upon a person who receives usury, who pays usury, or someone who's engaged in that business transaction. These institutions, unfortunately, are after financial gains using Islam, and this is the bottom line. I don't care. You bring me the name of that mufti, or the name of that mufti, or the name of that mufti. كل يؤخذ منه ويرد إلا رسول الله. You can say no to everybody except Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. These individuals do not have evidence to legalize, to make it lawful for Muslims to deal with these institutions in order to buy their homes. That's the bottom line. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you, to make you content with what you have and turn it into a blessing, and always think of the house in Jannah. You know, there is a house in Jannah out there awaiting you and your family. But remember, for you to get the house in Jannah, sacrifices have to be made. Jannah is expensive. Yeah, pay taxes on rent. The mortgage, you don't pay taxes. I understand. That's part of the price of Jannah. أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ غَالِيَةَ أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ هِيَ الْجَنَّةِ السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.